Hello, today we're going to show you how to change your inner tube. To change the tyre, you're going to need tyre levers. You're going to need an inner tube. You're going to need a pump. And in my case, I'm going to need a 6mm Allen key to open the through bolt. Tyre's got a puncher. Make sure that all the air's out. To open it, I will twist it. Take the bead comes away from the wall of the rim, which makes the work removing the tyre that much simpler. Tyre levers, place them in there. They also have a hook there that you can clasp around the lever there that it doesn't slip and go back in. So we will do it like that. It's clipped in. Open, move it around. That's fallen out because the tyre's ready to come out. Remove the broken inner tube or the punctured inner tube. Take the tyre off, something you've got to take off to check. Go around the rim and check the tape. There's no damage to the tape. That is sitting good in. So that's okay. To check the tyre, that nothing's gone in, no glass, no thorns or anything, a nail, whatever, you run your hand inside, but with caution in case you cut yourself on glass or anything sharp object inside. You can also turn it inside out and make it safer that you're not gonna really hurt yourself, and give it a proper check through that there's nothing sticking through. You find a thorn or whatever it is, make sure you remove it properly. That means either pulling it out this way, usually better to pull it out the other way. Pulling it out, and then making sure by moving it about there's nothing left inside there. So this tyre is perfect. There's nothing wrong with it. Let's put it back on the rim. Always paying attention that the rim is going to go that way, and the tyre also has a pattern, and there's usually an arrow that tells you what direction the tyre has to roll. Make sure you place it on properly. You can use a tool as well, but they usually go on by hand the first part. New tube. Let's get a bit of air in it, just to help it sit better in the tyre. Holes there for the valve. Put it in. Valves comes out. Okay. Make sure the tube is completely in the tyre. Okay, it's a bit off there. I usually push the ventil a bit up to sit that in properly, to get it properly bedded in. You then pull it down afterwards. More often than not, you can do this completely by hand. Okay, that's on. Went pretty easy, that. If you have problems getting the tyre on, you can also use your tyre levers. Gently put it in. Be careful not to trap the inner tube with the nose, because we've put it in, pump your air in, ain't gonna work. So gently, don't force nothing. And the last bit you can often squeeze by hand. Inner tube's placed in, tyre's sitting nicely on the rim. Next thing to do is just go round and check that there is no inner tube caught between the rim and the tyre. If there is, you put air in it, you're going to have a bit of a surprise when it goes bang. Right, that is top. Now I'm going to put air in it. Each tyre has a limit on it of how much air it can take. This one here is 60 psi, which is roughly 4 bar. I will usually put, for myself for this bike, I put 2 bar in, which is plenty. So you've pumped your tyre up to, say, on this tyre, maximum 4 bar. You've got to make sure that the tyre is sitting properly in, but that it's also come out. There's a line here, which you just follow, which goes round, and when it's all out, the tyre's gonna roll smoothly. If it's still stuck in, it's gonna be up and down, up and down, up and down. Tyre's now ready. Back in the bike. Ready to roll. I hope you found this video helpful. For more content, subscribe.